What's up, everybody? Y'all come on in. We got another unique one for y'all today. Yeah, come on in. What's up, Diana? What's up, Alexis? Yeah, come on in. What's up, Patrick? Yeah, come on in. We'll give him another minute, y'all, and we'll get started. What's up, Kayaru? What's up, Kevin? All right, how about we gonna get started? They'll come in when they come in. Now, this one here is called UnderVerse Chronicles. Let's discuss the NetherRealms the Cabal comes from. You know, from the state of our planet and our history, we've seen that these beings that are in power, the elites, the Cabal. Is a name that we know they've given themselves. We know that they've fucked the planet up, right? And you know they've done many bad things to the planet and the people, all everywhere. You know, they just went around the planet conquering for the last at least 600 to 1,000 years. You see what I'm saying? We know that for a fact. So yeah, what's up, Anna? So yeah, we know that for a fact. You see what I'm saying? What's up, Kendall? And what's going on here is these beings still consider this to be paradise, even though the planet is fucked up. You see what I'm saying? In our eyesight. You see what I'm saying? The original ones' eyesight. Even though we're the ones oppressed, we're the ones locked down, we're the ones in distress, and we're the ones fucked up. These beings, you know, the indigenous beings of this planet, these beings here consider this society to be paradise. You see what I'm saying? This is their Garden of Eden. You see what I'm saying? But if this is paradise to them, and we know we consider this shit to be fucked up, then what do they consider to be fucked up? You see what I'm saying? If this is paradise to them, what do they consider to be fucked up? And so this is what this is about, you know? There's going to be a lot of referencing to the movie Chronicles of Riddick. You see what I'm saying? We're going to really get into that. You know, this is what inspired this lecture, the UnderVerse Chronicles. Because I was asking myself while I was watching the movie, like, huh, they think this side of they think our world is fucked up. So what do they consider paradise? You see what I'm saying? Well, they think our world is paradise. So what do they consider to be, like, bad? What do they consider to be fucked up? You see what I'm saying? So let's get into that. Let's get into that. So now, in the Chronicles of Riddick, you got this group of beings called the Necromongers, right? You know, or just another way of saying warmongers. You see what I'm saying? Warmongers. Now, they said that they hail from the Underverse. You see what I'm saying? Now, what is the Underverse? The Underverse is these nether realms, you know, these lower dimensional frequencies that's below this dimension here. You see what I'm saying? That vibrates lower and denser than this dimension here. Yes. Yes, you have dimensions that's lower and more fucked up than this realm here. Best believe it. And you, here go a little book for y'all called The Gates of Dozak. You see what I'm saying? By Michael W. Ford. And they talk about gaining access to these four hell realms, right? Now, these four hell realms let you know or give you an idea. They are training grounds to teach you how to deal with these underverses. You see what I'm saying? These nether realms. And so, what's going on here is these necromongers, or aka the cabal in our world, these cabal elites in our world, who work for the archons, are from these dimensions. You see what I'm saying? They are from these dimensions. You see what I'm saying? You see what I'm saying? What is the underverse like? Well, now, they give you an example of what they like in the movie Jet Li the One. You see what I'm saying? At the end of the movie, if you remember that movie. You remember that he had to go to the Hades system. And the Hades system was just fucking one big prison system in the multiverse, right? So let's look at that. Let's look at that real quick. Let's see what that's about. It's Jet Li the One.
Fresh fish. Got a pretty mouth. I am Eula. Nobody's fish. You are mine. I don't need to know you. You only need to know me.
And look at the ram he in when they zone out. As you can see, it's one big prison ram.
Thank you.
Now, they're saying something, right? Now, they show you in that particular movie the different dimensions that he go to find his alternate selves. Some were looking good, advanced, futuristic, vibrating on a high frequency. Some was in the middle, like where he went to go kill the last version of himself, which is the middle world. You see what I'm saying? This is indigenous teachers. You got the upper world, which is the heavenly realms. The middle world, which is the mid realms. You see what I'm saying? Mid gods. You see what I'm saying? The middle frequencies. You know, the medium type frequencies. And then you got the underworlds. Those realms that's vibrating on a low frequency, which you just seen. That realm is literally one big prison realm. You see what I'm saying? Prison dimension that they ported him into. So and they literally called it the Hades universe. So that universe is nothing but one song. You see what I'm saying? So that song is literally and Hades literally means the grave. You see what I'm saying? So it's a dead song. You see what I'm saying? You see what I'm saying? So that's what's going on. That's what's going on. So this is what you're dealing with these beings, these necromongers that they showed you in this particular movie, Chronicles of Riddick. They show you, I like how they give you like a world view of what these beings are like. When Riddick, who in this movie is Set Heru, you know, he a dual god. He kills one of their members for killing Keith David in the movie. You see what I'm saying? Who was the Tehuti or Jehuti archetype, right? You see what I'm saying? A Jedi in the movie. You see what I'm saying? That they kill. So, they have him come into, they had a black woman in the movie. I forget her name already. They had her being, Black Archon, like usual. You know, you got a few of those who's lost their way, working for them. This is how it is. So they had her guide him into the room, the feminine energy, right? Guide him into the realm that they're living in. And what he sees is, when he looks to his left, he sees these beings with this, they get stuck in the neck. You see what I'm saying? By these machines. Now, what does this represent? They tell you in the movie that, oh, it's the mark of the necromonger. Or in our world, that would be the mark of the archons. You see what I'm saying? Mark of the vampires. You see what I'm saying? So the celestial vampires, that would be their mark. So they tell you, it's cause in the Bible that's Yalabor's book. So the book of Revelations, they're talking about their revelations from their point of view. You see what I'm saying? Against us. The beast in the Bible is only our melanin monsters. But the real book of Revelations from us would be Yaldabaoth and the Archons. You see what I'm saying? And their numbers being 616. You see what I'm saying? Number of the Archons. What would it be? They showed you in the movie. It would be then your neck, which is where your throat chakra is, and that would represent corrupted truth. Or it would be in your head, which is a calcified pineal gland. You see what I'm saying? Or a vampiric pineal gland that's vibrating on ELF frequencies, kicking out extra low frequencies. You see what I'm saying? Those archonic frequencies. So this is what's going on here. This is what's going on here. That's what's going on with these beings. You see what I'm saying? You see what I'm saying? So they go on to tell you that there are seven Lord Marshals, right? There are seven Lord Marshals. Now, y'all think seven is the chakras. In a way, you're right. But they're not talking about the standard chakras as you know them. The root, the crown, the heart. No. There are actually subpersonal chakras or shadow chakras that vibrate below the root chakra. And they're known as Tala chakras or T-A-L-A chakras. And I'm going to give y'all an example of that real quick. You see what I'm saying? Y'all an example. They look like this. They usually relate to your lower body, your hips, your thighs, your knees, your ankles, your calves, your feet, you know. So there are seven of them, and I'm about to go over them. The seven subpersonal or shadow chakras or Tala chakras that they call in East India are a tower, which is located at the hips, and it's about fear and lust. Then you got Vitala, which is at the thighs, and it's about rage and anger. Then you got Sutala, which is at the knees, and it's about retaliatory jealousy. Then you got Tala, which is at the calves, and it's about prolonged confusion. Then you got Rasatala, which is at the ankles, and it's about selfishness. Then you got Mahatala, which is at the feet, and it's absence of consciousness. You see what I'm saying? Or absence of conscience. You're just starting to sound familiar, right? Then you got Patala, which is on the soles of the feet, and it's about malice and murder. You see what I'm saying? You see what I'm saying? So that's what these seven chakras are about, Tala chakras. Now, to us, this is the lower world, the underworld, right? But to them, these Tala chakras are their primary chakra system. You see what I'm saying? These Tala chakras, what we know is the root, the sacral. No, replace those chakras with the chakras I just called out, the Tala chakras. That's what they vibrate on. Like in our current school, it's opposite of what we see in Daywalker school. You see what I'm saying? It's the shadow side of the equation. You see what I'm saying? It's opposite of what's going on over here. You see what I'm saying? Over here, we about ascension. Well, over there, it's about descension. Every chakra you activates makes you more archonic. You see what I'm saying? So when you inherit that archonic spirit from them, you vibrate on your Tala chakras now. You see what I'm saying? And so this is what these beings naturally have, because they are born in these nether realms that only deals in Tala archonic frequencies. You see what I'm saying? So that's what's going on here. So their root chakra is the Tala chakra. Their sacral chakra is the Vitala chakra. Their solar plexus chakra is the Sutala chakra. Their heart chakra is the Tala chakra. You see what I'm saying? Their throat chakra is the Rasatala chakra. Their third eye, or first eye, as we also said, chakra is the Rasatala chakra. Yeah, did I say it right? Yeah, no, the Mahatala chakra. And finally, their crown chakra is the Patala chakra. You see what I'm saying? So these chakras here, which we know as lower energies that vibrate below the root chakra for us, are literally their standard chakra that sits here. You see what I'm saying? And when they activate these chakras and start to vibrate on these chakras and awaken their chakra system, guess what? They become more archonic and vampiric and vicious. You see what I'm saying? This is what this is all about. This is what this is all about. This is what the blood sacrifice is all about. This is what the conquest is all about. This is what deceptions and wars are all about. It's all about mastering their chakra system from their perspective. You see what I'm saying? They don't master their chakra system like how we master our chakra system. You see what I'm saying? Because they don't have the same chakra system as we do. You see what I'm saying? That's what's going on here. They are completely different beings. That's why they are pushing this narrative that we are all one on this planet, when obviously we are not all one, because we don't all do the same shit. You see what I'm saying? Obviously we not all one, cause them motherfuckers is doing shit that we would never even dream of doing. You see what I'm saying? The corrupt shit that they doing, we wouldn't even dream that even, we wouldn't even wish that on our worst enemy, some of the shit that they doing to these people on this planet. You see what I'm saying? We wouldn't even wish that on our worst enemy. We could whoop that motherfucker ass, but we wouldn't send them down here to deal with them motherfuckers. So obviously they not from here. You see what I'm saying? They don't hail from the mid world. You see what I'm saying? The mid realm, which is what an earthly realm is in this material world. They hail from the underverse, the underworld. And that's what the CERN machine was all about. The CERN machine is about connecting with their dimensions and bringing in their archonic forces to what they do, what they said, body snatch. Now, if you ain't vibrating on, if you ain't master your chakra system, then they gonna come in and master your chakra system for you. And your chakras literally transmute from the standard chakra system of the Daywalkers to the chakra systems of the Archons. You see what I'm saying? Now you see what's going on here. The Starwalkers, the soul beings, it transmutes to Archons. And that's why when you meet certain people on the planet, And you walk up to them, you can feel they self-hatred. You see what I'm saying? You can feel that hatred from them. Because their heart chakra is not the heart chakra that you know and love. Their heart chakra is the Tala Tala chakra, which is all about prolonged confusion. That's why if you stay in their system for too long, their frequency or their electromagnetic field for too long, you start to become confused and frustrated. You see what I'm saying? You see what I'm saying? This is not a joke. You see what I'm saying? This is some real shit. You see what I'm saying? These necromongers is some real motherfucker. That's why you didn't get another Riddick for about a decade after that. Because they showed you some real shit in this movie. You see what I'm saying? They gave you seven Lord Marshals here. You see what I'm saying? And these seven Lord Marshals represent the seven Tala chakras. You see what I'm saying? Shadow chakras are subpersonal chakras to us. But it's shadow chakras, standard chakras to them. But to them, it's the chakras of the Archons, because that's how you master Archon school. The whole objective is to make it to your Patala chakra, which is the chakra of murder and malice. The highest level of fucking beings do the most killing. Have y'all noticed that on this planet? The ones with the most power on the planet do the most killing. Albeit they may not do it themselves, but they hire other motherfuckers to do it for them. But they probably at one point did do it themselves, because usually they had to, as an initiation, they gotta kill somebody just to get in the game. You see what I'm saying? Just awaken this crown chakra. And so what people tell you who's killed somebody feels like I died a little bit inside. And every time I kill somebody, I die a little bit more. That's what Will Smith told us in Gemini Man. When I kill somebody, I die a little bit inside. And the more I kill, the weaker my soul got. The more disconnected from my soul I became. And this is what we're dealing with these beings. We're dealing with beings who are not of our world, who operate on a whole different system of our teachings, which they hide themselves, because if they knew, which they are, you know, even if you see it on the Facebook, a part of you gonna always say it's still speculation, because you're not viewing it with your eyes physically. But if they knew, if they keep it secret, because if we really knew or we really seen what they was really doing, then we would be rebelled against them. You see what I'm saying? So that's what's going on here. That's what's going on. So they keep all that crazy shit that they do in secret, and they have their own rituals. Blood sacrifices is just one. That's the blood sacrifice is probably the highest level. You see what I'm saying? Because now you're on your crown chakra, but you got other levels that you have to do. You see what I'm saying? You got other levels and other programs in place to do different things. Cause there are seven levels to the government, if I'm not mistaken. You have of course the legislature, the judicial, and the executive, but you also have Hollywood, which is the media, the fourth branch of the government. You got Big Pharma, the fifth branch of the government. You got the military, which is the sixth branch of the government. And then you got the financial, the monetary system, which is the seventh branch of the government. You see what I'm saying? These five branches are ironically connect with these seven chakras. You see what I'm saying? Each one of them promotes something. You see what I'm saying? So let's see here. Now, the sixth chakra is interesting because it deals with the absence of conscience or consciousness, right? If you notice, these motherfuckers is cold fucking hearty. See what I'm saying? By the time they get to their sixth chakra, their version of the third eye, they heartless. They cold on the inside. They frozen, and all they can see is what you would say, murder, mayhem, ruin, and chaos. You see what I'm saying? Negative chaos in this case, toxic chaos. You see what I'm saying? That's all they see at that level. You see what I'm saying? So that's why there's no consciousness here. There's no love here. There's only hatred here, and rage, and frustration, and misery. See what I'm saying? That's why they look so old and terrible and ugly and fucked up. You see what I'm saying? That's what's going on with these beings, y'all. These beings are not from here. Obviously, they're not from here. If they consider this world to be paradise and it's fucked up like the way it is, then where are they from? What do they consider to be fucked up? Ask yourselves that question. You see what I'm saying? You see what I'm saying? What do they consider to be fucked up if this world is paradise to them? You got to ask yourselves that. Now, what is their philosophies? The Necromonger speak of their philosophies in this movie. Now, they tell you in the movies that life is meaningless. You see what I'm saying? Life is meaningless in the movies. You see what I'm saying? Like, you can't get nothing out of it. Their teaching is known as nihilism. So they were nihilist as well. What the life in the middle world, because they were just going around destroying planets and conquering people. And on their journey to the UnderVerse, which is the NetherRealms. You see what I'm saying? The Underworlds. So on their journey to the NetherRealms, they were just going around the mission, destroying beings. Until they got to Helion Prime, which is the soul. You see what I'm saying? They got to the soul. Because Helion Prime was literally a sun. You see what I'm saying? And that whole dimension was the sun, the solar realm. You see what I'm saying? They found their way to the Daywalkers now. You see what I'm saying? But they realized that, wait a minute, sometimes evil can't be defeated by good. Sometimes evil got to be defeated by another evil. And I'm going to let you hear that, you know. I'm going to let you hear that one real quick. Go. As you can see, she said evil can't be defeated by good. Sometimes evil has to be defeated by another kind of evil. Interesting, right? There's a trip, right? So these beings, she tell you they are an army like no other. So they are intergalactic, they interdimensional warmongers. Check. They crusading across the galaxy or the cosmos, pretty much fucking shit up, killing people, destroying their worlds in the name of their religion, which is nihilism in this case. You see what I'm saying? Nihilism. You see what I'm saying? So they are nihilists. You know, people who see no value in this particular dimension or this particular version, the middle world of this particular realm. You see what I'm saying? They don't see no value in it. But that's a little bit of a lie. Because obviously they do see value in it because they don't want to give it up. Because it's still paradise to them on our equation. So they do see value in it as far as fucking pimping us for our resources, keeping us being their slaves and working for them and doing their trash. You see what I'm saying? So that's a half-truth there. So, shit. Then we got these motherfuckers converting people to their cause. So they opened up a school of Archons on our planet. School of the Archons on our planet, and they're inducting motherfuckers into their shit only if they play by their rules. You see what I'm saying? So the celebrities, the people in power, you know, the Illuminatis, as you said, you know, these names they usurped on our planet, who they took our information and turned it, you know, using it against us. That's all they've been doing, you know, our war. So they using beings from our planet, and they not telling them what the fuck is going on, most of them anyway. Some of them do know what's going on. They're not really telling them what's going on, but we'll pay you to we'll pay you to help us continue rulership on our planet. You see what I'm saying? We gonna give you the money, but all you gotta do is these little rituals for us, you know. You know, do a little work on the side every now and again. Do a fucked up movie. You know, make some fucked up songs. You know, do it. You know, we'll hook you up. You see what I'm saying? We'll give you a few mil just to show out, and goddamn, just to show up and show out in our favor for the most part, right? Because they just told you that if they can't convert you, they'll kill you. So for all the motherfuckers who don't join their cause, put it like this: that's our enemy, y'all. They teach them that they're our enemies, and we must make sure that they don't rise. So, what did they do? They created organizations like the Boule, Freemasonry, you see what I'm saying, and various other organizations across the planet to keep the indigenous people of the world in line, you know, the greater masses, everybody who is not of their order, in other words. Like they said in the Matrix, if you're not one of us, then you're one of them. That goes both ways. If you're not a daywalker, you're potentially an Archon. Well, if you're not an Archon, then you're potentially a daywalker. It's a two-way lane. All right, so we got that. Check. Now, they also tell you that they're world enders. So whatever is happening on your planet, they roll up on you, and your planet can be prospering. But to them, that's fucking, that's a sin. That's an error. That's a mistake. How dare you prosper in this world that we see no meaning in, no life in, or the half, which is kind of a half truth, or we see life in on it from a perspective of we're gonna rob you of your resources. We're gonna take your women, rape them, kill them. We're gonna take your children, perform rituals on them and program them, and we're gonna kill your men or imprison your men. You see what I'm saying? See where we're coming from. So, and we're gonna destroy this society which you so know and love. Check. Now, she pretty much told you the game of what these beings is all about. You see what I'm saying? They even showed you in the movie how they destroyed planets at the beginning of the movie. Now, they tell you about the Lord Marshal, the seventh level. Remember, Archon, the lockdown numbers are 3, 7, 12, and 13. You see what I'm saying? So in this case, we're dealing with the 7. You see what I'm saying? We're dealing with the 7 at this time, the taller chakras. So the Lord Marshal, who is always, we always dealing with the 7 chakra, the Lord Marshal, who they said in the movie, they said precisely, he is a holy half dead who has seen the underverse. Or in other words, the holy part is he half angel, but he also half dead because he half vampire. Who is that describing? Y'all the bull, the demiurge. Yep. So he represents the demiurge here. So they literally rolling around the material world, fucking shit up, y'all. Yeah, definitely. So what does y'all the bull represent? What do you get from half angel, half vampire? Your ego. In this case, the celestial ego. A being who has convinced himself that he's the almighty, and if you don't honor his thought process, he will come and fuck you up. That's basically what they're saying here. That's basically what's going on in this Chronicles of Riddick movie. Now. So, Riddick, you know, you had part 1, which is known as Pitch Black. Pitch Black was the original one. Then you had the little animated movie, which was Dark Fury. But Chronicles Ridge was a part, was the third one. You got the fourth one that came out, which was a remake. But the Chronicles of Riddick, they tell you that Riddick is the ultimate evil. He's the antithesis to this being. Why is Riddick the antithesis? Riddick, in their eyes, is evil because he don't play by their rules. Still, he still don't play by the system's rules in this realm, in the middle world. You see what I'm saying? He's a rebel by their eyes. So that makes him Set Helru. You see what I'm saying? He's a Sith Jedi. You see what I'm saying? Or he's a Jedi Sith. You see what I'm saying? He honors both the dark and the light sides of the Force. So where do we find Riddick? Riddick has left and went to a planet. You know, after shit went down in Pitch Black and they escaped that planet, he decided to get away from his friends who would be in danger because he always had mercs on his back, or mercenaries on his back, right? So he decided to live on a frozen planet. You see what I'm saying? Of course he did. The frozen planet represents the calcification of his pineal gland and the calcification of his energetic frequency. Well, Keith David, who was his friend, I don't remember the name of Keith David in the movie, but y'all know his real name, so that's good enough. Keith David, who is Tehuti or Jehuti in this movie, summons Riddick. What he put? He put 1.5 million on it, which is six, which is the awakening. So we already dealing with the fusion of the feminine and the masculine energies. He put a bounty on his head to get him, and these mercs come after him, and that summons him back to the galaxy at large. And he even said it in the movie, back to the brightness and everything I hate. You see what I'm saying? It's always that dual energy with him, that Set energy, that Session energy, and that Heru energy, right? So he gets to Helion Prime, which is actually his soul. You see what I'm saying? This is his soul. So he goes to Helion Prime, meets up with Keith David, and he asks about Jack, who was it was a little girl in the first movie. And, you know, Keith David tells him that, you know, she left and went on to do her own thing. And later on in the movie, you'll find out she's become Kira, who is now the Oshun Sekhmet, also another dual goddess in the movies. She's become the Oshun Sekhmet in this movie, or the Sekhmet Oshun. You see what I'm saying? In this movie. So she represents his heart chakra, his love, and his, his feelings. You see what I'm saying? His emotional energy. Now, this is when he rolls up and they kill Keith David and they introduce him to this Necromonger way. And while he's in the building, these beings, these three beings, which, you know, the three magi always show up. The three magi represents what? The pineal, pituitary, and the hypothalamus. But they're in the Necromonger energy, so they're being used archonically, I guess you could say, vampirically, because they lock down themselves, and they trap him in this little beam or whatever, tractor beam. So they begin to enter his mind and find out his ancestry. So come to find out, Riddick is part of the Furians, from the Furian system. Who are the Furians? The Furians are our ancestors. You see what I'm saying? His ancestors. You see what I'm saying? They represent our ancestors now. And that's when he find out who he really is. You see what I'm saying? So, they even show he got minor telekinesis when he used the blade, which was a Furian blade, and he used it, and, you know, he showed his abilities with it. It's his skill with it. So now, what's going on here? He goes to, he escapes them, because now they find out who he is, so they try to kill him. He escapes them, and he goes to Crematoria, which is prison, which is, where Kyrie is, and his heart chakra is pretty much locked down. And they meet up, they talk, whatever. They escape the prison. Now, when they escape the prison to get back to the hangar, who's waiting on them? The Necromongers, because they tracked them, whatever. So they fighting or whatever, and then, you know, he gets shot, or he gets caught in the middle of a crossfire, and so then they knock him down. So what happens? They begin to get ready to kill him as he's kneeling down on the ground. And all of a sudden, time slows down, and the goddess, Sophia, walks through the portal and tells him, "Hey, yo, we think you see it now. You can see it now. You see what they've done to us, and now we're giving you the power, the ancestral power, the cell energy, because that's what the energy represented." And she touched him. To the right. She touched him on what? His right breast, and she poured the energy of the ancestors into him, and it caused an awakening and an explosion of force in all directions, right? And I'm about to show y'all this scene, because that's a powerful scene. The scene is literally called The Power From Within. You see what I'm saying? Let's see here, gently the one. There we go. That's the one.
So, you can kneel.
As y'all can see, there was him having his awakening. You see what I'm saying? There was him having his awakening. She touched him. Five fingers, five elements, and awoken the force within him. The ancestral force living inside him, the ancestral power, and it erupted in all directions. And what color was it? It was green. So now he's an empath, because he was an empath the whole time anyway. You know, mainly a physical empath. But now he's tapped into his full ancestral power. And it erupted out of him and knocked everybody back. Now, the white-haired dude that y'all seen in the movie also was a Furian. And it was on his left breast. You see what I'm saying? So they show you that duality, the feminine and the masculine energies. You see what I'm saying? The right side of the body is considered to be masculine, and the left side of the body is considered to be feminine. Well, the dude with the feminine energy saved him, but told him, "You got it now. I'm done with this shit. I had to say so much horrible shit in this program," because he says in the movie, "We all started as," at the beginning of the movie, he says, "We all started as something else." So he walks out into the lava and kills himself. So that energy gets transferred to Riddick. You see what I'm saying? All that power gets transferred to Riddick. So he gets both the energies. You see what I'm saying? So now he has all the power, the ancestral power, to do what needs to be done, because that was his feminine energy who saved him from getting smoked by this lava. You see what I'm saying? Cooked by this lava. So and he dies because he was no longer needed. He fulfilled his purpose. He was an ancestor. You see what I'm saying? Looking out for them. See what I'm saying? Aetherian ancestor who, you know, you had the feminine, you always got the Sophian energy who stepped through the portal to touch him and gave him the feminine power. Then you got the masculine energy who was already there, who saved him from death and taught him who he really was and transferred that. That's the Baphomet, the god, the Sophian god, the Gnostic gods of wisdom. And the Gnostic god of wisdom is the Baphomet. So then after he did that, he dropped the body. That's what you see when he walked to the lava. The lava represents what? Heat. So, you see what I'm saying? This is what you got going on here. So now he got all the power. That energy transferred to him. He got all the power. So he goes to save Kira. You know, he infiltrates the Necromongers. And he starts fucking shit up and goes to save Kira. And he battles Yaldabaoth, the Lord Marshal. You see what I'm saying? And, you know, he's catching hell with this motherfucker because, you know, he can separate his spirit from his body. You see what I'm saying? So he catching hell because he never seen nothing like that. Hell. He got the shine in his eyes. If y'all notice, Riddick always had purple eyes, you know. That just represents enlightenment. You see what I'm saying? That he received from a witch doctor. In the game, he went through these Jedi trials and unlocked those abilities. You see what I'm saying? And so his eyes begin to shine. The eyes of Heru. You see what I'm saying? The left and right eye of Heru, the moon and sun eye. You see what I'm saying? And the moon and sun eye represents your pineal and your pituitary gland. And the shine represents your soul. You see what I'm saying? And which was purple, the crown. You see what I'm saying? So all this here was enlightened. He was enlightened. You see what I'm saying? So since he was enlightened, he was free. And he was, and since he was free, he did whatever the fuck he wanted to do, and he was, of course, a glitch in the matrix of even the middle world. But shit was so dire, they had to fucking summon him for this situation. Now, there was an elemental in the movie who was telling the story there. You know, so you're always dealing with the elements as well. The elements is always there to help you. The elementals is there to help you, like they showed you in the movie. And she was there witnessing this fight. And the fight went down, you know. He had some help from Kira, but they killed her. But that's what fucked him up. And then it was another warrior, Necromonger, who was trying to take his place, who was dating the black chick. He jumped down to try to kill him, but his spirit moved and fucking drug the physical body with it. And guess what? Riddick had timed that shit perfectly. As soon as he got there, he stabbed that motherfucker in the top of the head, which was his crown. You see what I'm saying? And he killed his ego, or Yaldabaoth in this case. And that's when he ascended to the throne of the Necromongers. And their code was, you keep what you kill, which is, I've told y'all, that's horror occultism. Keeping what you kill is whatever you destroy, whatever you kill, you conquer. You see what I'm saying? Sometimes in the monstrous world, you dealing with these monstrous beings, they try to attack you and fuck you up. And so you got to defend yourself, and you got to fuck them up before they fuck you up. And once you destroy them, you conquer the energy that they represented, the archetypal energy that they represented, whatever type of energy it is. You see what I'm saying? In the monstrous, in these nether realms, that's how they get down. You see what I'm saying? That's just how they get down. It's not your fault or my fault. That's just how the monstrous realms work. You see what I'm saying? Another thing I want to touch on. Riddick was in the prison crematorium, and they released some wolves. They had the same eyes as Riddick. They had the same shine as Riddick. Now, one of the animals found Riddick, and he took off his glasses, and they locked eyes. And all of a sudden, the animal calmed down and relaxed because Riddick had animal communication and a connection with it. And that was showing you Riddick's connection with his spirit animal, his soul animals. You see what I'm saying? His guardians. So, because they had the same eyes as Riddick. You see what I'm saying? So that was his spirit animal. And they turned from what? Gray or black to red, which is their root chakra, their sense of survival, because your spirit animals, your soul guardian, your spirit animal guardians, your soul animal guardians always got your back. You see what I'm saying? And if need be, if you're in a dangerous situation, they will flip on that switch for you to tap into your animal nature if it comes to matters of survival. You see what I'm saying? Definitely. That's what they represent. That also represents really conquering his animal nature. You see what I'm saying in this movie? So definitely. Yes, definitely. So, yes, the mark, which is probably the most powerful thing in the movie that he received here, is the mark of the ancestors. You see what I'm saying? They call it the seal of God in the Bible. You see what I'm saying? The seal of God, or the mark of the phoenix, which you receive in your mind's eye, or you receive it on your hand. But they showed you in the movie, you can also receive it in your heart chakra when you fully awaken it, which we know as empathy. You see what I'm saying? And you upgrade to what? An empath. Children of the green ray. You see what I'm saying? Agreeable beings. Agreeable beings are nothing but empaths, elder souls who've come down here to finish what they started. You see what I'm saying? First heal themselves, regenerate themselves, and take their planet back later on. That's what we're here to do. So as star seeds. So and all you gotta do is a little bit more work to upgrade from empath demigod level to a full god level by making it back up to your crown chakra and having your kundalini awake. So that's what's going on here. That's what you're seeing with his experience. And so he took the throne, which means he was at his crown chakra after he talked to Kira or whatever, who was the feminine energy, his Oshun setback in the movie. You see what I'm saying? His love, so because he had feelings for her. So she dies, and you know, he becomes the king of the underworld. You see what I'm saying? He becomes the new Anubis. You see what I'm saying? Low key, the underworld rose, Anubis rising. That's basically what this movie is. Anubis rising. You see what I'm saying? Baron Sumdi rising. Baron Samedi rising. So definitely. This UnderVerse Chronicles is literally the necromongers in this movie is telling you that they're not from here. They're not from this dimension. You see what I'm saying? The Cabal is not from this dimension. They from some fucking wells. You know they're not from this dimension. Why would they fuck up their own planet? You see what I'm saying? You got to ask yourself that. Why would they fuck up their own planet? Their own realm, if they actually was from here and knew that they were stuck here. You see what I'm saying? Obviously, they not stuck here either. Because if they knew they were stuck here, they would do their best to take care of this motherfucker. But we not seeing that, obviously. We not seeing that. So, guess what? They all about keeping this shit locked down. Keeping this shit, keeping us in a state of ignorance. In a state of fuckery. So, end of the movie, he becomes the god of the underworld, but at the same time, he saves his own soul. If y'all noticed that. Because they was getting ready to destroy Helion Prime, which is Riddick's soul. So, they give you that melanin and that soul energy as well. You see what I'm saying? That dark soul, as I also call it. The necromonger energy, which he conquered, this is literally represents him conquering that black dot, that dark soul, that black sun inside of him. So, which simultaneously saves the golden sun. You see what I'm saying? His divine spark, his divine consciousness. You see what I'm saying? So that's what you're seeing here at the end of this movie. That's what you're seeing here. So definitely a very powerful movie, telling some very hidden secrets about these beings on this planet and what they're all about and where they hail from. And they all about what? The Crusades, which is what Christianity was. Where they launched like 7 Crusades. No, they never stopped launching crusades. That's what motherfuckers don't understand. They never stopped launching crusades up under the banner of Christianity, their Jesus. You see what I'm saying? You see what I'm saying? Christianity is their Jesus. Y'all don't understand it. We bomb on Jesus. A lot of beings like, why y'all bomb on Jesus? Because there's two Jesuses. There's Gnostic Jesus and Gnostic Christ. And then you got Christian Jesus and Christian Christ. There's two. Gnostic Jesus is the real Jesus. Gnostic Christ is the real Christ, because Gnosticism is the original religion. And Christianity, they say they burn these Bibles. They burn the Gnostic texts, which were a compilation of books in one book, which we could call the Gnostic Bible. That's what they burned back in the day. And they gave you the Hebrew Bible, which is the Book of Yaldabaoth. How we know it's the Book of Yaldabaoth? Because literally God in the Bible is an asshole. Let's be for real here. It's called it what it is. God in the Bible, God in the Hebrew Bible, the King James Version of the Bible, is a fucking asshole. He a fucking ass. Let's call it what it is. Let's call it like we see it here. Let's not ignore what we really know. Let's keep it real here. That nigga is a bitch nigga. You see what I'm saying? He's a bitch deity. So hell, you know he a bitch deity. Hell, he pick on his own beings, the Israelites. Who is the Israelites? Well, his representatives down here at this time are known as the Khazars, who are manifested at this day and age as the Jesuit priests in Israel. You see what I'm saying? These archons. He got the Jesuit priests in Israel. He got the Boule over here. He got the Roman Catholic Church in Europe. He got the fake Shaolin Temple and other monasteries in China. That's what, you know, in China, I told y'all, they're destroying all the Buddhist and Taoist temples, except for the Shaolin Temple, who they made their mission to burn down 400 years ago, but they ain't fucking with it now. They destroying all the other temples. Come on now. So that they work for the Pope. That's why. Next, you got, of course, the African leaders. You know, they work for them as well. They got their own little organization going on down there. See, the South American leaders, we already know here, they just killed some indigenous people down there. And they were trying to protect what? The Amazon, feminine energy. You see what I'm saying? The Amazonian forest, which is the feminine energy. That's what Amazon represents, the warrior aspect of the feminine energy. Now, then you got Australia. They trying to destroy Australia too. You see what I'm saying? You see what I'm saying? Because Australia is literally an island nation of Lemuria. You see what I'm saying? So they tell you what they doing. They not doing these things you see for no reason. They know that these are the places that we were supposed to rise again. So they getting a jump on it and destroying it. Don't get me wrong, nature is doing her own destroying as well, but nature is fucking up the motherfuckers who trying to fuck us up. You see what I'm saying? You see what I'm saying? So nature is attacking their worlds. You see what I'm saying? Their cities and earthquakes and banks and shit. You see what I'm saying? That's what nature is attacking. Their system, their monetary systems. They're big farmers. I told y'all the medicine won't work soon, so get into your life force teachings. The medicine, the big pharma companies don't work. We already know the political scene, the judicial, the executive, the Congress. We see that. We of course, that's blatant there. Shit, so the political scene. Then you got the media. Oh, yes. We best believe it's an agenda in these movies and in his music. Now, they know they can't get us with the music as much thanks to YouTube and the underground, so don't nobody listen to mainstream music like that. Everybody just downloads their music from iTunes, YouTube, and various other places. You see what I'm saying? So they can't get you as much with the music, but they still gonna push it because they know some kids still listening to the radio because it's so available still. Now, the seventh one is the military. You see what I'm saying? And finance. Of course, I already said the monetary system. You got the military. They being fucked up too. You see what I'm saying? Because they dumbasses going out there warring for these motherfuckers and getting fucked up by the Anunnaki. You see what I'm saying? These so-called, if you've been listening to Twisted Truth on YouTube, and he's been getting these secret documents from one of the agents in the KGB, he telling you what's up. They going to war with these Anunnaki, and they getting their asses kicked. The Russians and whoever else who helping them. You see what I'm saying? They're getting their asses kicked. And America and Donald Trump trying to join in. That's what this Space Force is all about. So all of a sudden, we got a Space Force? And it took y'all all this time to reveal it? Because y'all so-called said we weren't ready? But the world was a way better place in fucking the 60s and 70s and 50s than it was now. So what took so long? You see what I'm saying? What took so long for a fucking Space Force? You see what I'm saying? You gotta think about these things. Like, y'all brought a Space Force out now. What's going on? What y'all need a Space Force for all of a sudden? You know, they care about money so much. Goddamn, according to the story of Otis T. Carr, who actually created a spaceship back in the day, with mind interface technology, they came and raided his ass. And their literal excuse was because it would destroy the monetary system, which it would, because you would know if you got spaceships, what the fuck you just need to adhere to one particular governmental system for? You know, it's just common sense. So they knew a lot of people would leave the planet and just travel the cosmos. So of course they had to go shut that down. But if it was such a monetary problem back then, and y'all's trillions of dollars in debt, you still found a way to fucking do this? You still found a way to produce a Space Force, which they've had the whole time, by the way. So we've been doing about Area 51 and all type of other locations that had spaceships. So you mean to tell me all this time you had a Space Force and We've been down here suffering on the planet, and you could have been did something about it with all these resources from all the other planets, and now it matters? Come on, y'all. Come on, y'all. Use your common sense here. You use this logic. You use a sense of reason. There's no fucking reason for them to wait this long to show a space force. Oh, it gets better. So, you know, Corey Good and all these motherfuckers, David Wilcock and they whole team of white motherfuckers, because everybody's white, them. So they already make me suspect. Ain't no other races in that bitch but white people. We already know that's a secret society then. Of fucking space agents. You see what I'm saying? Secret society and space agents. So you mean tell me y'all got all these advanced technologies and y'all waiting for some special time to bring them out? You see what I'm saying? You just can't bring them out now when we need them the most. You got healing technology that can heal the sick. Fucking, you got technology that can heal Down syndrome. They can heal all these other diseases on the planet, and you wanna hold on to it until some prophesied time that may or may not come? Come on now, y'all. Come on now. Let's use some reason here. Let's use some reason. Yeah. I was curing none ain't them but the Oracle program. I already told you that. And Donald Trump is in the MAGA movement is the architect program in the Matrix. They already programmed you 20 years ago with the Matrix. You see what I'm saying? 20, 30 years ago, they programmed you. You see what I'm saying? They are and you accepted it because you have a subconscious relationship with Donald Trump, which is the architect program, and a subconscious relationship with QAnon, which is the Oracle program. But they told you, the Oracle told you, I work for the Matrix. So she's still working for the Archons. You see what I'm saying? The architect pretty much let you know, yeah, we still work for the fucking Archons. You see what I'm saying? Because he literally said we. So he was the spokesperson for the Archons in the movie. We are willing to make sacrifices. You see what I'm saying? He basically said we. Who is we? The Archons. Celestial vampires. Who they're working for. You see what I'm saying? So they telling you what it is. And dude, old boy was wearing all white. And he had the same kind of hairstyle, same little cool, slick hair Donald Trump got right now. Come on now. Shit, MAGA movement. You see what I'm saying? MAGA. Make America great again. Who's America? You see what I'm saying? The indigenous America or the United States Corporation? That America. You know, you got to ask questions, you know. Because, you know, we ain't got a Space Force. I want to let y'all know that. We ain't seen a Space Force. And I researched for about a year this Space Force shit and this QAnon shit. I ain't seen no other races, not just black people, but I ain't seen no other races in the media besides white people and one Asian. One Asian, y'all. One motherfucking Asian. They probably just let him in there because, you know, he probably built something for him or some shit. He probably a scientist or something. Or engineer some shit. So you mean to tell me that they gonna save you, and they promoting saving you? You know they kind of be nice and say, well, you know, you're supposed to save yourself, but I always pay attention to the but. There's a conjunction that states that yeah, we're saying this. Well, wait, hold on now. There's more. You see what I'm saying? That's a hold on now. There's more. But at the end of the day, we are going to be your saviors. We're going to be your Jesus Christ. That's the savior syndrome. See what I'm saying? You said, yeah, you can save yourself now while we get shit together, while we getting the program ready, you know. But once after we get the program ready, we going to be your saviors. You see what I'm saying? They're Space Force, which, like I told y'all, they already got jobs online for that shit. You know, $50,000, $70,000 a year, bare minimum. Setting it up. And they're going to set it up out there in Huntsville, Alabama. I went out there about 2 years ago. Half the fucking, they tore down all the fucking stoves out there. Half the land is gone. So they're going to put the Space Force in Huntsville, Alabama. Watch, see what I tell you. There's one of the main, there's going to be one of their main locations, you know, that they building. Because who the fuck tears down half a city? Y'all tell me that. Because Huntsville was well known for pioneering the Space Force energy back in the 50s, 60s, and 70s. You see what I'm saying? Along with Houston, Texas, you know. So definitely, y'all gotta pay attention here to what the fuck going on. See what I'm saying? You gotta pay attention to what's going on. Number one, physically, nobody there looks like you. Matter of fact, nobody there looks like most of the planet. There's only one group of people that denotes a secret society. Number two, they had this space force all along. I've read their books, and they said they've had this space force since the fucking 50s, and it's been advanced since the 80s. So fucking, what took you so long? That's like 40 years. You see what I'm saying? It's like 40 years. Cause it's 2020 now. That's 40 years. So it took you so-called 40 years. We know they've had the space force the whole time because they're not from here. They're necromongers or warmongers. They also call they nihilist. You see what I'm saying? These are all their terms. These are all their philosophies. They don't honor it now because they have free will, because they operating up under a free will system, so they don't have to honor their doctrines. But best believe, the main motherfuckers who know about this shit is honoring those doctrines. You see what I'm saying? That's why he put them out there. Next, where was I? Yeah. So you got a secret society of one race of people on a planet with multiple races of people. Shit. You got a space force that's so-called been in existence for over 50 years. You know? Shit. Now, they want to bring this space force out of nowhere because they're warring with interdimensional species who they term the Anunnaki. Haven't we been talking about the Anunnaki for about the same amount of time that they created this space force? Damn. How fucking coincidental. Anyway, we've been talking about the Anunnaki since the 50s. You see what I'm saying? 60s. They've been dropping fucking Anunnaki teachers since the 50s and 60s. Hell. So, ironically, they've been building a space force since the 50s and 60s. Damn, that's a fucking connection there, right? So, the same shit that we've been talking about, they've made the enemy online. Because these beings are us from the future. You see what I'm saying? These Anunnaki gods and goddesses, warriors and warrioresses, you see what I'm saying, deities, have us from the future, and we're sending our futurists to protect us back here to help free the planet, because they doing even more diabolical shit because they've been fucking up the timeline and been getting help from our cunts from the future, and they helped them build this CERN machine so they could get into other interdimensional realms to bring in more of these nether beings from the nether realms to help them fuck this planet up more. And so now they underground working on fucking trying to, they literally trying to trap souls in space and time. Even though you can't, I've experienced it, because I actually experienced it with Kobe Bryant now. You see what I'm saying? They was trapped in a time prison. So on some levels, they have gotten that shit right. You see what I'm saying? But not the physical archons. The celestial archons have, because you got both, have figured out a way to trap your soul in this time prison if you leave here and you don't know who you are. You see what I'm saying? So they can trap you in that time prison and suck off your light energy, your source light. And feed them for a while until somebody come save you. And back in the day, they had an astrolite where the soul would come, and they went into the astrolite, their ass would be dropped right back down here, pulled right back down here into a womb forcefully, and they would be born again. You see what I'm saying? So all these terminologies, and that's one of their favorite statements. Oh, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, will be what? Born again. Jesus Christ is your soul, the crucified one. Will be born again through the astral light, which they created to keep you falling back into the cycles of reincarnation. They telling you again, these beings ain't from here, y'all. They playing a whole different ball game. A ball game that we ain't never seen before, and we're just now getting fully hip to. You see what I'm saying? What they really about. You see what I'm saying? These some dastardly motherfuckers. You see what I'm saying? These some deadly motherfuckers. And we now understand to the level and degree of what's going on here. We now just now fucking get to the depths of how fucked up and dangerous these beings really are. And now the word's out thanks to the age of Aquarian energy and the information age on the planet. The word's out on giving us an idea of how dangerous these motherfuckers are. So we can no longer underestimate them, and we will be taking these motherfuckers out. Best believe that. 2020 is almost here, y'all. Also, like I said, the Gates of Dozak, primal sorcery, can teach you how to master these. They take you to 4 hell realms to teach you how to master. They known as the Yatus. See what I'm saying? Look at the book. So the Yatus are Sumerian in nature. And they practice Yatuk Dinoi, which is a primal form of witchcraft. Or sorcery, you see what I'm saying? So this primal sorcery trains you in the art of chaos magic and wielding it just like the Sith in Star Wars, so you can protect yourself and know how dangerous these motherfucking beings are on this planet. You see what I'm saying? So the Yatus, the Sumerians, are actually either a latter day incarnation of the Yezidi, the Sumerian Jedi. You see what I'm saying? The wielders of the Force. And this is one of their books that was hidden, known as the Gates of Dozak. You see what I'm saying? And they are masters of primal sorcery. This here, what you see here, y'all remember the magic circle in most of your teachings? This is actually a reverse magical circle. You see what I'm saying? You see what I'm saying? And this is known as, and Dozak, Gates of Dozak actually means the Book of the Worm. You see what I'm saying? You see what I'm saying? The primal sorcery. So definitely. And they got the Anunnaki on one side. And then it's like a line. I'm going to say. Looks like a line in a way. Let me look at the picture. Yeah, it's a line on the backside. So they telling you your monstrous nature, your fierce nature. But at the same time, you're God. You see what I'm saying? Because those are just technically the wings of Isis in my eye. You see what I'm saying? Definitely. You see what I'm saying? So there you go. The feminine energy. That circle is always the feminine energy. And those two little lines there is the phallus. The dick, I guess you could say. So definitely. That's a definitely. Because you know, it's funny. This book is magic, metaphysical, and Satanism, right? Now, God in the Bible is Yaldabaoth. You know, just another little observation I made. God in the Bible is Yaldabaoth, the Demiurge, according to the Gnostic, right? The Hebrew Bible, the King James Version of the Bible especially. If God is Yaldabaoth in the Bible and Satan is the adversary, then who the fuck is Satan then? We now know that Satan, who is the adversary of Yaldabaoth, is your soul. Satan is your soul. The adversary to this being is divinity and the source of all, the all. You see what I'm saying? So the primordial forces. Setup mode is off. Just a moment while this device reconnects. Yeah, the primordial forces of the world, the primordial forces of the world, so Satan is your soul. In the eyes of God in the Bible, who is Yaldabaoth, the Demiurge, the celestial ego, the original archon. You see what I'm saying? So that's mind-blowing shit, right? So Satanism is the melanin secrets of your soul, or the dark soul inside of you, that they don't want you to tap into, because when you tap into that primal sorcery, that chaos magic, they can't do shit with you down here. But just like they couldn't do shit with Riddick in the movie. They couldn't do shit with him. He was a monster because he was free. He was an enlightened being. So that's what's going on here. So definitely pay attention to what's going on here. Everything is ass backwards. They tell you Satan, the adversary. Because we know Lucifer is the light bearer. And we already know in Isaiah, Lucifer was trying to get back to the creator, the original creator, the source of all. And this guy, Yaldabaoth, was trying to, the celestial ego was trying to talk him out, or snapping on him, or cussing him out for goddamn trying to get back to the source of all. You see what I'm saying? Because Lucifer in this case represents your what? Your soul. You see what I'm saying? Lucifer is the light bearer. Do y'all not know that there's a Gnostic Lucifer too? And in Gnosticism, Lucifer and Christ are the twin children or the twin sons of the great mother Sophia, the righteous sons. Anyway, you know, she got an illegitimate child, which is Yaldabaoth, out of wedlock. So, you know, and esoteric wisdom became exoteric wisdom in Yaldabaoth's eyes because he thought he was the only god. You see what I'm saying? So everything became overt, not internal. So that's what's going on here. That's where these bids come from, y'all. Definitely. Make sure I hit everything, because those were some big thoughts I really want to let y'all know. Like, nah, Satan is your soul. Lucifer is your soul. Because God in the Bible is Yaldabaoth. You see what I'm saying? No bullshit there. He tells you that he's in the Bible in the Tower of Babel story. So he tell you who he is in the Tower of Babel story. So if they don't believe me, go read that Tower of Babel story and you tell me what God bestows limitations and boundaries on you. You would think that the true creator, the true source of all, want to see you reach your highest heights. Go study Gnosticism. You see what I'm saying? If y'all don't believe me, go check that shit out. I hope you don't believe me. Go check it out for yourself so you can see what I see. And then you be like, yeah, Satan is your soul. The adversary is the soul, the divine spark. Lucifer, your soul, the light bearer. Cause yeah. And Jesus never died on the cross. That's bullshit. You see what I'm saying? That's not in the Gnostic teachings. Jesus ain't died on the cross. Judas died on the cross for him. You see what I'm saying? Judas died on the cross. The betrayal. He died on the cross because he was in Christianity. He was known as the betrayal. But in Gnosticism, Judas was Jesus' best disciple, and he took that hit so that Jesus could continue the ministry of Gnosticism. You see what I'm saying? So definitely, y'all gotta wake up and see what the fuck going on. You in a different kind of war, an interdimensional, fucking temporal warfare. Interdimensional, temporal, which just means time war. You see what I'm saying? Best believe what you in. You see what I'm saying? Hyperbolic time war around here. Interdimensional time war. Best believe. This is what the fuck is going on around chill. So, with that being said, make sure I hear everything, y'all. Yep. That's pretty much it. Know who you dealing with. Know thy enemy. Know thyself. Know thy team. And most importantly, know thy environment. What's the name of the book? It's called Gates of Dozak. D-O-Z-A-K. By Michael W. Ford. I put the name in the description as well. So, best believe, know what you're dealing with out here, people. So with that being said, I'll take questions now. So yeah, just know, everybody, this shit is ass backwards. Everything you think is like Pastor Troy said, vice versa. What if heaven was hell and heaven and hell was heaven? Vice versa. So he basically, that's why he kicked him out of the industry for that song. You know, he didn't get two or three more CDs and they kicked his ass out. Cause vice versa. Cause that's what that was his most popular song. Cause everybody's soul resonated with that song. What if heaven was hell and hell was heaven? What if God was the devil and what if the devil was God? What if God, Yaldabaoth is actually the devil, adversary, and the devil, your soul, is actually God? Colleen Dempster, is Jesus a deity? Yeah, Jesus is actually Heru. The Gnostic Jesus is Heru. Yeah, the ancient Egyptian Heru reborn in the Gnostic teachings. You see what I'm saying? The Persian Abraxas, as he also is called. D Knight, what's the difference between the two Jesus? Gnostic Jesus teach you how to get the fuck up out of here. Regular Jesus just died for your ass. Regular Jesus, You know, he kind of give you some hints on how to get out of here, but he don't. You don't really hear from his mouth. You actually hear from his. You at least hear from his mouth in narcissism. I gotta get the fuck up out of here. You see what I'm saying? See what I'm saying? And you know, you got the only way you get up out of here is freeing your soul, basically. You see what I'm saying? And whereas in Christianity, he tries to tell you that, but it's from everybody else's perspective, so it's second, it's second and third hand truths. And he dies on the cross for you, which is just your soul being crucified in his physical body. That's what the crucifixion story represents. But they also give you a hint that that same soul who got crucified can also get free again in the story as well. But nah. Of course, we know Jesus is black. We already know that, you know. As they tell you that in the Bible, in a Hebrew Bible, shockingly. But see, even more, Jesus is Heru. Who is this black guy? You see what I'm saying? It's Heru. See what I'm saying? You know, it's one thing to know he God, but who, which God? He Heru in ancient Egypt, and he Yahshua in Samaria. You see what I'm saying? You see what I'm saying? And he Heru in ancient Egypt, he Yahshua in Samaria, and then Persia, which is the last great empire, Abraxas. Let's see. And Kush, Ethiopians kind of use the same energy as ancient Egypt and Nubia. So, you know. So, yeah, there you go. Colleen Dempster, name of the movie? Chronicles of Riddick. Riddick. R-I-D-D-I-C-K. It's a trilogy. The second movie, now the first movie you can watch just to get an understanding, but the second movie is one with all the metaphysics. Chronicles of Riddick. Brandon Christos. So this means we are supposed to resist the Kundalini Awakening if it is rising to the top? No. You have your Kundalini Awakening. Yeah, this is the age of the serpent here. You're not telling y'all that either. The age of the knockers. You see what I'm saying? The age of the knockers. The return of the knockers. So, yeah. You definitely had that Kundalini Awakening. That's what this energy is all about. The Aquarian energy is all about freeing your Kundalini and freeing your soul. You see what I'm saying? Through the Kundalini experience. You see what I'm saying? Definitely. So there you go. Any other questions before I get up out of here? Yeah, do know your enemies is always hard at work, people. Always hard at work. Like I said, the same time they so happened to be building the Space Force in the 50s and 60s is the same time the Anunnaki teachers started coming out with Dr. Dilma Blau at the spearhead and then Dr. York later on. So come on now. That's too fucking coincidental. Then when we finally get the consciousness and knowledge and we start the awakening, you know, and start to free ourselves from this dimension. Then they come out with the Mandela effect to slow that shit down because the matrix was starting to break up like it was supposed to and fall apart like they showed you in Inception. Then they demonized the Anunnaki, which were the same beings, which was who they was preparing for in the 50s and 60s because they knew they was going to return, which is us. Yeah, which is us. Best believe. This ain't no game. These motherfuckers know exactly what they doing. They know exactly how to fuck us up. They know exactly what they doing. It's all counter warfare measures. It's all counter warfare. For every good, there's a bad. For every positive, there's a negative. And so they're feeding off the negative. They're creating negative narratives to combat our positive ascension. You see what I'm saying? There you go, Colleen. They're killing themselves. Right. The coronavirus. Asians eating fucking serpents and shit. During the age of the serpents. Because the age of Aquarius, also known as the age of the Phoenix, is actually the age of the Kundalini rising, which is serpent energy. Kundalini Shakti. And they're eating serpents, which are now considered sacred. And now they got sick from that shit. And now they dying in mass amounts because they over there eating snakes. Who the fuck eat snakes? see what I'm saying? See what I'm saying? Shit just crazy. Shit just crazy. D nice. Why is it so hard for our people to wake up? They up on this arcane spell. And that shit hard to break. Even the star seeds will tell you, D, that this shit hard to break. When they was locked down. You see what I'm saying? It's a magical spell, which I talked about in my Yaldabaoth 616, Yaldabaoth spell 616 video. There's a spell on our people. This is magic. This ain't no fucking game. This mystical mathematics. They've hexed them with their arcane magics. You see what I'm saying? And their minds are locked in a state of suspended animation. That's why they can get up every day to the same old shit and be happy. See what I'm saying? That's what the spell do. It keeps you locked in a state of suspended animation and have you think that this is all there is. This is why you put the dome over the plane, this plane of existence, all that shit. Just to keep you locked in a state of suspended animation. Like they showed you in the Matrix. What it was, everybody was locked in a state of suspended animation, being fed off of. You see what I'm saying? Because this a feeding ground. Planetary. That's the ultimate goal, to make this a planetary restaurant. See what I'm saying? Because all divine sparks down here. And they tell you in the Bible that the angels are jealous. Who is these jealous angels? The archons. You see what I'm saying? You see what I'm saying? The jealous angels are the archons. You see what I'm saying? Because what? Y'all the boy tell you what in the Bible? He is a jealous God. And a jealous God is going to produce jealous motherfucking generals, which were archons, celestial vampires, who are all half angels, half vampire, which they're about 98% vampire and about 2% angel now. So yeah, they don't fuck with their angelic heritage. They only fuck with their vampiric heritage. So yeah, they made their choice long ago. So there y'all go. There you go, Brandon. This shit very hard to break. Any fucking starseed will tell you that. And we can't hear half conscious, and it's still fucking hard to break. A lot of these people can't hear whole, fully sleep. You see what I'm saying? We can't hear half sleep, and it was hard to break. So, motherfuckers who are fully asleep, you know how hard that shit is to break? And you fully asleep, you got to start from square one? Shit, we can't hear at least half the program broke. They can deal with the whole program, the whole spiel. I've never known the whole spiel. They have known the whole spiel. See what I'm saying? See what I'm saying? So yeah, that's what's going on. So you know, don't hate them. You know, it's frustrating. They think you crazy, but don't hate them, cause they was up under that spiel and we was there. We halfway know the fuck they dealing with it, at least. You see what I'm saying? See what I'm saying? Colleen Delta. So the dome is real on this planet? Very. According to the supreme law of chaos, which is change, everything changes and everything transforms. The sky don't change. It's blue in the day and at nighttime it's fucking these star patterns, which I swear I think are magical seals or magical symbols. But I'm still doing research on that. I'll get back to y'all with that later. And these magical symbols and this magical dome that's over us never changes. No more than clouds in the sky. That's it. So, yeah. Yeah, definitely. D-Nice, so what do you think about this COVID stuff? Are they feeding off him? Yes, they feed. They was feeding off him until I freed their souls. Now they're just, you know, where it is. He didn't even die. He wasn't even in the helicopter. They just kidnapped him. And goddamn got him locked up and feeding off him like they would in the Matrix. You see what I'm saying? And it just replaced his body with another being. You see what I'm saying? So definitely. So they do that as well. They switch you out and they know you got them guide codes, some of them in you activated. And they want those codes to try to access, to gain access to the primordial frequencies that's on the rise right now. Yeah, definitely. Colleen Denzel, so are the angels real, like archangels, OMG, are they actual meaning archons? Angels are real, but there are two types of angels, you see what I'm saying? You got daywalker angels, star seeds, you know, the elder souls of the cosmos. And then you got these motherfucking Yaldabaoth angels who are actually celestial vampires. You know, they have breeds. You see what I'm saying? You see what I'm saying? Like they tell you in Constantine, you the one should go. Like Keanu Reeves told fucking Gabriel in Constantine, you the one should go to hell, half breed. He ain't lying. He ain't lying. Yeah. Half breeds. That's what they are. Half angels, half vampires. So, yeah. There y'all go. Given that we created them, would the seven archons be considered our soul versions? Well, we didn't create them. An angel created them. What happened was, since these motherfuckers went rogue and all fucking chained down here, we came down here to transmute the material world to something new, destroy it and recreate it to something new. But they stopped us from doing it, and we've been warring with them ever since. That's basically what happened. So these 13 beings, you know, Yaldabaoth and his 12 generals, they stopped us from fucking this shit up. Cause we, you know, we always go around the galaxy monitoring all the dimensions, and when we get to certain dimensions, we see they fucked up. We opt for their destruction, and we recreate them to something new. You see what I'm saying? So we opted for this realm of destruction, and before we could complete it or fully do it, they ambushed us and we went to war with them. See what I'm saying? Colleen Dempsey, we never see stars anymore where I live. Nah, Colleen, you ain't never seen stars ever. How about that? That shit you see in the sky is literally just a pattern. Those are sigils. You see what I'm saying? Those are celestial sigils that they're using to keep this dome sealed. You see what I'm saying? So who are we speaking to when we are asking for help to the archangels like Michael? Now, the archangels, you see what I'm saying? The archangels are not from this this material world. So you got the angels of this material world, and then you got the angels that precede this material world. See what I'm saying? Or what we call the order of star walkers or day walkers or solar guys. You see what I'm saying? When you say Archangel Michael, you're talking about the solar guys from the solar realms that precede the material world. You see what I'm saying? You ain't fucking with Yaldabaoth. You know, as long as you're doing it from within here. Because if you pray out there, you pray into their ass. Because, you know, they looking at this shit hard right now. Best believe all eyes is on Earth right now. Best believe that shit. See what I'm saying? Because this is what they call the blue gem. You see what I'm saying? And they trying to keep this blue gem down here because Mother Earth has so much power and free energy. Colleen, then so is it good when we keep saying number seven? Yes, seven is a spiritual number. That is, seven represents God, you see what I'm saying? And awakening to your God power and God self. So yeah, I think I'm gonna get on up out of here, y'all. I think that's it. Yeah. Yeah, stars don't exist. Or stars may exist. Yeah, how about that? But we don't know what they actually look like because we ain't never seen them. See what I'm saying? At least not with our physical eyes. You may have went to fucking your inner self and seen actual stars and actual souls. But we don't actually know what the fuck they look like because we ain't never seen the actual sky, actual space. So there you go. D Nice, we already at war, homie. Do you think we make it out of 2020 without a fight? Or what's your thoughts? Yeah, we already at war. Yeah, we've been fighting the whole time. Everybody just waking up to the fact that they're at war. Enjoying the war. Choosing sides right now. Everybody choosing sides right now. You either with them or you with us at this point. Alright, well, I'll see y'all later. You know, I'm Marvin Jones. Y'all put the word out. Share this with your friends. You know, check out my other lectures on the Midnight Order, occult lectures. I go hard, go in. And y'all enjoy. Peace.